Hi everyone, Saeed here. Today I'm going to teach you a mind-blowing infographic design in PowerPoint. First, let's check it out. This is the infographic slide that I'm going to teach you today. But why is it mind-blowing? Because you can design it in less than a minute. Let me show you how. Before we start, let me introduce an incredible website which is called gosplit.com. You know, a lot of you always complaining that you don't have morph transition because you are using older versions of PowerPoint. But what if I tell you, you can upgrade to Office 365, the best version of Office, with only $2. Yes, you heard me correctly, $2 for Office 365. And it is not only about Office. You can buy Spotify, Netflix, YouTube Premium, and also you can buy the most popular VPNs from this website. Let me explain more. If you click on the link in the description, it will navigate you to this website. Click on the Go Split button to see the magic. On this page, you can see all the products, such as NordVPN, Apple TV, Apple Music, and other products. If you go to the Software tab, you can see all the available software. Look at the price of Office 365. It is even better than Black Friday. Also, we have Adobe, Canva, Photoshop, and so many different software. In the music section, you can buy Spotify, Apple Music, YouTube Music, and some other apps. But my favorite part is the security section. On this page, you can see the most popular VPNs in the world. For example, I bought ExpressVPN for almost 2 euros. Let me show you the actual price. On the ExpressVPN webpage, you have to pay almost $13 per month. But on the GoSplit webpage, you only pay 2.2 euros, which is fantastic. But we are not done yet. Let me click on one of the apps to show you another feature. Here you can see all the people who are sharing their subscription. For example, you bought PureVPN family membership and only you and your friend are using it. But what about the empty seats? We still have 8 empty positions. You can share your subscription on gosplit.com and find new people for the empty seats and receive money. Isn't it awesome? I hope you found this information helpful. If you are using older versions of PowerPoint, I highly recommend you to upgrade to Office 365. Alright, let's dive in and start the tutorial. Let's start by adding a text box to the slide. Inside the text box, type 1, enter, 2. Now right-click on one of the numbers and click on Convert to Smart Art. Then select this style. Let me increase its size a little bit. What if instead of 2 numbers, I had 3, 4, 5, or 6 numbers? Do you see that? We can create these shapes by only typing the numbers. And by using them, you can create these infographic slides. In the template file, I have prepared all these slides with different colors, and all of them are fully animated. I will put the download link in the description. In this video, I'm going to teach you how to design 6-step infographic slide. So repeat the process. Right-click, convert to smart art, and select this style. Let me adjust it, then right-click on it and ungroup it. You should ungroup it again. We don't need the numbers, so click on the border of one of them to select it. Then hold the control key down, select all of them, and delete them. Now I want to increase the size of the shapes. Since I don't want to distort the aspect ratio, first I have to group them, then increase their sizes. Remember, if you hold the control and shift keys down, shape will grow from the center. Okay, align it to the middle and center. Perfect, we can ungroup them now. Make sure all the shapes are selected. Then from Shape Format tab, Merge Shape section, choose Fragment. First, let's delete the center shape. Now hold the Ctrl key down and select these shapes. Then make them union. Okay, the first part is ready. Repeat this for the other parts. Press Ctrl A to select all of them, right click and select Format Object. In this window, set the transparency to 0 and remove their outline. Also, add an inner shadow to the center. Set the transparency amount to 50 and blur to 40. Draw a rectangle and set its height to 6.8 and width to 12.6 and align it to the middle and center. Let's fill it with a gradient fill. We only need two spots, so delete these two. Make sure the radial type is selected and direction is from center. Choose black for this spot. And for this one, I am going to use this color code. So open More Colors window and type the code here. Let me add a drop shadow to the center as well. Set the transparency to 30 and blur to 25. Now you can send it back. Let's change each shape's color. These are the color codes that I'm going to use. We learned how to use these color codes, so I'm going to expedite this section. Okay, so far, so good. If you liked this video so far, please like and subscribe to the channel and ring the notification bell for additional upcoming videos. Alright, let's get back to the video. Now I'm going to add some icons to the slide. From the Insert tab, click on Icons and add your suitable icons to the slide. First, change their colors, then change their sizes to 0.6. Now put them in these positions. Let's group each shape with its icon. Hold the Ctrl key down and select the icon and its shape. Then by pressing Ctrl G, group them. Repeat this for all the shapes. Now click on this little icon to add a text box. You should type your title here. Change its font if you like. In this case, I'm using the Objective font style. Also, choose uppercase to capitalize all the letters. Let me add a text box for number and another for details. Select both of them and group them. Repeat this for all the shapes. Alright, everything is ready. Since we want to use the morph transition, we have to duplicate the slide. In the first slide, we have to drag everything to the outside to animate them. But can I drag them wherever I want? No. Let me explain. Which one is better? This one or this one? You know, the position of shapes are highly important. In first slide, when you drag a shape to this position, you are commanding to the morph transition to animate next slide like this. So if you want a symmetric movement, you have to adjust them precisely. Let me zoom in to show you something. What do you see in the center? A hexagon. And each point belongs to one shape. So add a hexagon to the center of the slide. Then hold the Ctrl and Shift keys down and increase its size until all the edges are in the outside. Send it back, then drag each shape to its point. For example, this shape is for this point, so drag it here. Repeat this for all the shapes. Also, adjust all the text boxes like this. Go to the second slide and select all the shapes. Now hold the Ctrl and Shift keys down and decrease their sizes a little bit. You know, this section is personal. If you like this shape, keep it as it is, but I prefer this one. For the last step, go to the Transition tab and add Morph Transition to this slide. Now your PowerPoint is ready. I will put the download link in the description. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did and you haven't subscribed to the channel, please consider subscribing. Alright, I'll see you in next video.